You're doing white. I think I did indigo purple.
Yeah.
You know, oh, then an energy mix like that does different types of healing. You know, so a lot of times I use white light and I switch to indigo. You know, white light is cleansing and very powerful. Indigo is gentle and healing. You know, I noticed that differences of the power of it. But anyway, once we did that, there was tears of joy. He was laughing and running around.
Tears of joy, laughing and happy.
People were coming to see him. You know, we used to talk to him. I think we gave him a hug. He gave him a hug or something.
His grandmother.
This kind of overweight lady came.
Black lady. Grandmother.
It was family. I knew it was family. You know, Mike Easy came. You know him. Mike Easy came walking in. And he's like, "What's up, brother?" And be easy. He always says that. Mike does that a lot. We see him on the other side frequently.
Yeah.
He's like, "Man, brother, be easy. It's okay to cry." You know, and you know, it was like a celebration. You know, and you know, Christ was coming there to consult with him on the forgiveness issue he had in his mind.
Right.
You know, Lord Buddha was there just watching, you know, and then some other spirits came. They just take him out. I think they went off with Christ and with Mike. Several other ones came, some of his friends, you know, that have died.
He brought him to the restaurant.
But, you know,
reality show.
This is, you know, but, yeah, speaking of Mike, you know, I don't want to go into this too much, but, you know, a lot of people know him, and, you know, not to get into any family's business, but to his friends and all, I think he wants you all to know that he's very happy, man. We never really talked about Mike that much on video, but, you know, Mike is very happy, man. He's at peace, man. You know, he's in a beautiful place, and... You know, he's been more than beautiful, a fucking incredible place, this dimension. You know, and he's there. He's spiritually advanced. You see what he did with Pee-wee this morning, you know. I didn't ask him to come. He showed up. I was sitting there watching. I was standing there in that dimension with him. There he comes, you know. Doing his own share, letting them know it's okay to cry, brother, you know. And he's like, just be easy. It's all right to cry. This is say a few other things, but things like that, you know, this is the kind of things we, Jeremy and I, experience on a daily basis,
yeah.
Stuff like this, continually, you know, and this is what we do, and this is why it's hard to explain to people what we do, you know.
It may seem strange or something,
yeah.
But the whole idea is to bring everyone together. We know that there's people on the other side trying to get to you. We're trying to get them unity, you know. Let's get it together, you know. Let's find ways to communicate with their past loved ones if we can. Let's move forward to making things right and less greed and determined to change the outcome of what used to be. The outcome used to be cry, fall apart all the time, you know, look for justice or whatever it is. But those things don't help the dead. I don't say the dead, but the ones that passed on or gone to different dimension, portal, whatever. It's a lot up to us how we handle these things, but the thing is, we need to agree, and if we disagree, that's okay.
Let me see what else we can talk about from current affairs. Well, we should talk about that guy. Speaking of people that were murdered, you know, we covered that one. There's another one with this white boy that guy, you know. I think I see him coming through. Like this white dude, you know, riding home with his girlfriend after some date downtown. And I think, like, got shot by accident. People popping odds and shots around the corner.
Right.
You know, let me see if I see him.
Kind of got like brownish, blondish hair.
Yeah, I see him coming through.
Yeah.
You know, like, because I think psychically, like, I could speak to this, you know, I don't think that the people doing the shooting were really going for this guy. No,
they weren't
They were not. No. They were just popping off shots, just being drunk and dumb.
Yeah.
That's all I got, we can say. They're just like popping off and just drunk, not paying attention, stoned a couple of them. You know, we're not condemning anyone. You know, I want to say this. We don't judge anybody. The killers, the people who died, what they've done, we don't judge anybody. You know, some of those words might upset some of you, but we don't judge people, and we won't judge anybody. We refuse to judge anyone. So understand that. As far as the other guy, man, if we're going to talk about this, you know, about this other dude, Jay, you know, basically, if you want to know, and I noticed that some of you probably want to know, you know, like, people there to rob him, you know.
Yeah.
He was outside, you know, doing his thing. And then, like, two dudes came around and tried to rob him of his shit. You know, he didn't give it up, but he ran off.
He tried to go the other way.
He went the other way, shot. I think he shot him in the back, he was showing us.
Somewhere in the back.
Back of the head, something like that. But he took off running. He didn't give it up. He said, fuck you. That's what I'm getting. Like, fuck you, man. I took off.
Yeah.
You know, he wasn't about to give it up, you know. But, this white dude, Billy or something. I think his name is Billy or something. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I see him. He's coming through clear now. Leaving clear. He's focusing in on for me a little better. But, yeah, brother, like, we're just sitting here, like, you know, I haven't had a chance to talk to you yet, brother, but... let us know, you know, if we can do anything for your family, if we, you know, we talk to people's families and whatnot. You know, we're helping somebody who died this morning out in the other part of town. He was murdered too. He was coming through, you know. So I know he's still getting used to it.
I think it's more about him getting ready for us.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, he's not ready. This guy's a little jumpy.
Yeah, jumpy. I was going to say he's doing cartwheels right now.
He's not controlling his thought. He hasn't learned how to control his thought patterns yet. When you're doing stuff like that, you have to learn to control your thought when you're on the other side. Because your thought, the moment you think anything, it's going to happen.
Absolutely.
So he's not stabilized his thought. He reminds me of Dante. Remember Dante?
Yeah.
You know, and after the monks came to retrieve him and help him, he was all right.
Big difference, yeah.
Maybe we could ask for their little assistance here.
When Billy's ready.
When he's ready, yeah. Look, Billy, this is some monks and Lord Buddha and Lord Christ and Lord Krishna, you know, that we work with all of them. And when you're ready, they will come and help you. You can go find them. You know, and they're going to help you get focused and teach you and show you around the spirit world.
Absolutely.
You know, let me assure you that we work with them all the time, especially Lord Buddha, and especially the group of Buddhist monks.
Yeah.
You know, they just were assisting the person who passed away early this morning and fought. So keep that in mind, you know. When they feel you're ready, they'll come and get you. Apparently, they're not ready quite yet. No. Otherwise, they would have already been there getting you. So, but you know where we are. So come find us when you want to. Not focus. We're here. Anyway, so this is something else. You see what we just did? This is how we handle things like this. You know, we can instantly check in and see what's going on with any spirit. You know,
just talk to them.
They're there, and then when you got the gift to hear and see them, it really makes a difference.
Absolutely.
You know, let me tell you about something I did like a while back. You know, there was a case you all might have heard about on the news that this guy was an older black dude. Not that race makes any difference. I'm just saying who it was, but you know, he would think he was in Churchill or maybe in the West End. Like, he got mad at his girlfriend. His girl walked out on him. Anyway, so he went on a killing spree. He went and killed her, and then killed some random dude running away from the cops just to kill someone. And then when they cornered him, he blew his head off. So anyway.